Hi, this is Dave Vellante of WookieBond.org, and this is theCUBE. We're here live at HP Discover. Duncan Campbell is here. He's the Vice President of Solutions Marketing at HP. Duncan, good to see you again.
That's right, Dave. Pleasure.
Yeah, so tell me what's happening. There's a lot of going on in the industry, software-defined, converged infrastructure. What's your angle on this?
You bet. So from HP's standpoint, we've seen really three key trends where we are actually seeing them and actually really leading out on them. So the first one is converged infrastructure. As you know, we coined that term back in 2009. And since then, a lot of innovation, a lot of proof points have been really very exciting to see coming out. And in particular at the show, we've seen a lot of new converged systems, a lot of very cool technology coming out, including some software-defined technology. So the first one would be converged infrastructure, second key trend on cloud, and the third is on software-defined.
Yeah, so what's your take on software-defined? I mean, how do you guys define software-defined? What is HP's unique attribute there?
Yeah, you bet. So software-defined is something where it makes a lot of sense. Why? Because you get the additional type of agility, and from our standpoint, you get additional performance and additional type of benefits from that. So one of the things that we did announce here is some new software-defined storage, and it's something where we've actually had offerings in there before the term came out and was cool. And so one of the things is we've extended our software-defined storage. We're actually already shipping 170,000 units to actually offering a new store once VSA product. So it's taking software-defined storage and thinking about the whole replication, deduplication, and backup around that. Our position on that, though, is this is something exactly what customers expect. So we're seeing those software-defined technologies coming into CI, and we're actually seeing the promise of that really coming across the data center.
So what makes it software-defined? Is it the fact that it's software only, or is it more than that?
Well, actually, that's a good question. So in our view, we need to offer both. So we will see certain classes of competitors and solutions just for software-defined only. And then we'll actually offer integrated and hardened solutions, like with our software-defined networks. But I think the whole point is there's really three tiers in the architecture. There's the whole data layer, there's the whole control plane layer, and the application layer. And our view on that, that's exactly what customers are seeing and say, but standardize it, and it can provide real innovation in terms of what we can offer, both within, let's say, software-defined storage or networking, and now even with Moonshot on our software-defined servers.
Okay, so you'll be delivering solutions around Moonshot. What might those look like?
Yeah, you bet. So a good example, and I think what's important for any type of vendor, if you really believe in this, do you eat your own dog food? Yeah. Not a pretty thing, but.
How about drink your own champagne?
Oh, yeah, see, that's why this guy's a pro. So from our standpoint, it's what we offer with our Moonshot is that actually runs our HP.com. So that has over 300 million hits a day. So it really talks about, like, for that type of web workload, how you can get that type of scalability, that type of performance, and that is a great example. And we're going to see more in that. So I think when you look at these different offerings, they'll be right for certain workloads, and certainly for new classes of data center, it'll be just a fascinating type of opportunity here for HP, our partners, and most importantly, our clients.
So Duncan, talk a little bit about open source. You guys are betting the farm on OpenStack, you know, so you're all in. Chips are in, we're in Vegas. Talk about open source generally, maybe OpenStack specifically. What's HP doing there?
Yeah, you bet. So a big announcement here in terms of what we talked about with our cloud OS. But even before that, it's been our belief that that's a source of innovation. And you know, to that degree, you've seen our offerings around open source, even with our integrated converged systems. So we have Vert systems that are built on open source. We really believe that that's going to be key. And why is it key? Because that allows you the ability to go, let's say, from a public cloud where you design something, move it into a private cloud, put in your confidential information you want to then burst out to, let's say, a managed cloud. You can do that all within the open source and specifically with the OpenStack.
Okay, and so a big part of that is you guys are making contributions to that community. How do you see that evolving into ultimately solutions? You're a neck of the woods.
Yeah, you bet. So I think the key is, you know, we'll really look at where that workload makes the most sense. But I think what's incumbent upon us is do that heavy lifting ourselves, do that type of testing up front to make sure that it is fully integrated, supported with the applications, and we provide the services worldwide. So what's incumbent upon us, do the heavy lifting, but look across what is needed, not just by silo. You know, those days are dead. We really need to have best-in-class products, but world-class solutions in terms of how we help our customers.
How do you think about the whole ISV community? When I think of open source, I think of open APIs, I think of services that you're providing through your platforms and your solutions. It just feels like, Duncan, it opens up a whole new world of innovation. Can you talk about that a little bit? Maybe that's even a new whole new customer set.
Yeah. So I think you're spot on. And one of the things we've seen that's important for this is to have a real ecosystem. So if you believe that, which we do, you have to have a program that really invites ISVs early to inspire them, you know, into the party. So we have our whole Alliance One program, which has over 4,500 ISVs, both traditional as well as new school. In some of the cases, people we've never even heard of. But the whole point is invite them to the party, get their innovation, and what I see, it really speeds up the process too. So my standpoint, wealth of innovation, and I think this type of approach will really unlock that type of innovation to happen.
Okay, so we're here in June at HP Discover. What should observers be looking for from the solutions group with regard to progress that you're going to make, milestones that you're going to hit? How should we be evaluating, you know, the momentum?
Yeah, so I think Meg said it well. She started out in her keynote talking about the big bets that HP is making. So around converged cloud, around security, around mobility. And so from our standpoint, in big data is so key. So I think what will be judged from our standpoint, just exactly what that customer experience is, how we actually help grow that business with innovation, with partners, with the ISV community. So I my standpoint, I'll be excited to come back in 6 months' time. We can get you over to EMEA Discover, and you can kind of see how we're tracking. And I think you'll be delighted to see the type of progress, because once the company gets that type of focus on a big bet, wow, watch out.
All right, well, so we'll see you in Barcelona. Thank you for the invite. I appreciate that. And thanks for coming by this remote cube. Duncan Campbell, appreciate your time.